क्यूब्स apscourses.com In this video on cubes, we shall read the cutting of cubes and then painting of cubes, the number of parts from cutting. If there are n cuts to a cube, there are a maximum and minimum number of parts that the cube can be divided into. If you cut the cube in parallel cuts, suppose you have 3 cuts in this figure, the cube has been divided into 4 parts. And now look at this figure. If the cuts are perpendicular, if the cuts are in x direction, y direction and z direction, then there are 8 parts that are made by 3 cuts. If there are n parallel cuts, the number of parts into which the cube is divided would be n plus 1. And for perpendicular cuts, if there are x cuts in the x-axis, if there are y cuts along the y-axis, and there are z cuts along the z-axis, then the number of parts in which the cube is divided, it is given by x plus 1 into y plus 1 into z plus 1. Let's have a look at an example. You want to cut a cube into 210 smaller parts. What is the least number of cuts required? Now, since we need the least number of cuts, we should cut perpendicularly. Let the cuts be x, y, z along the 3 axes. Therefore, 210 would be equal to x plus 1 into y plus 1 into z plus 1. And the most equal values for 210 is equal to 5 into 6 into 7. So we let x, y, z be 4, 5 and 6. And hence the total number of cuts would be 15. The next example. This is a cube. This cube is to be cut into 64 equal cubes. We need to find the number of cuts required minimum. It is given that rearrangement of pieces is not allowed. If the rearrangement is not allowed, what we do is we cut the 3 axes into 4 parts each. And therefore, the minimum number of cuts would be 9. The next example. What is the maximum number of parts into which a cube can be divided by 13 cuts? We let the cuts be 4, 4, 5 along the x, y and z axis. And using the formula x plus 1 into y plus 1 into z plus 1, the total number of parts would be 150. Painting a cube. Now this is a cube with dimensions 5 by 5 by 5. We have colored all the surfaces of this cube and then we have cut this into 125 smaller cubes of 1 by 1 by 1. We need to find the number of cubes having. The first part is none of the faces painted, one of the faces painted, two of the faces painted, all three faces painted. This is the figure. Let's look at the first part. No face painted. Now inside this 5 by 5 by 5 cube, there is a 3 by 3 by 3 cube inside this that is isolated from the paint. We cannot go inside the cube. And when we cut this entire cube open, that smaller 3 by 3 by 3 cube won't have any paint. And this means that one cube of 3 by 3 by 3 is equal to 27 cubes of 1 by 1 by 1. And these 27 cubes will not have any face painted. The second part, having one face painted. Now let us have a look at the figure now. In this figure, we only look at the top face for the time being. There are 9 small cubes which have only one face painted. All these smaller cubes of 1 by 1 by 1, they are indicated by the number 1. These 9 smaller cubes will have only one face painted. So a total of 9 into 6, which is 54, have exactly one face painted. The next part, cubes with two faces painted. Now look at this figure. Along this edge, we have 3 cubes that have exactly two faces painted. These 3 cubes that are marked 2 have exactly two faces painted. And therefore, we have 3 such cubes on each of the 12 edges. This means that there are a total of 36 cubes with two faces painted. Cubes with three faces painted. Now in this figure, all the 1 by 1 by 1 cubes that lie on the vertex, these cubes will have three faces painted, and hence 8 cubes will have exactly three faces painted. The next example, a cube is cut into 99 smaller cubes, and out of these 99, 98 are 1 by 1 by 1. We need to find the side length of the bigger cube, the original cube. Now let the larger cube have dimension A and the remaining cube have dimension B. Therefore, A cube is equal to 98 plus B cube. We are equating the volumes of the original cube and the 99 new smaller cubes. And hence A cube minus B cube is equal to 98. You can easily find that A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 3. And therefore, the side length of the larger cube is 5